You know it takes a lot of time to create email content, and you want to make sure your work gets out there. In this video, I'll talk about how deliverability works and cover best practices. At the end, I'll give you a key in improving your odds of reaching the inbox. Sound good? Well, let's get into it. Email deliverability is the process of successfully making it to a recipient's inbox. It's the bridge between you and your customers. With a strong link, your customers can get the messages they're expecting, which is better for engagement. And you'll have a more accurate picture of how your marketing is doing. So you'll know if you're getting the return on investments that you need. Don't worry, you don't have to be technical to follow along in this video. We'll mostly focus on the things that affect sender reputation. This is a score assigned by internet service providers and email services like Yahoo and Google. The higher your reputation, the more likely your emails are to land in the inbox. Sender reputation is determined by content quality, message frequency, spam complaints, and more. I'll go over a few of these in more detail. Let's touch on some of the most important things that affect sender reputation. I'll start with bounce rates. A bounce happens when an email fails to be delivered. There are soft bounces, which are due to a temporary issue like a recipient's inbox being full, and there are hard bounces, meaning the email address is invalid. If you have a high bounce rate, it can lower your reputation. Spam complaints say something about the quality of your targeting and messaging. Customers can mark any email as spam for any reason. Maybe they don't find the messages to be relevant, or they feel they're getting too many of them. And if you get enough complaints, the receiving server may automatically filter your emails to spam. Spam traps are made to catch senders with poor list building practices. For example, sometimes ISPs and email services create email addresses that were never used by a real sender. Spammers find these email addresses on websites or through purchased lists, and they market to people without their consent. When the recipient server spots one of these traps, the sender gets added to a block list. So to be on the safe side, only market to someone if they've given you explicit permission. And it's never a good idea to purchase an email list. For everyone who's opted into your email marketing, engagement is something to keep track of. By engagement, I mean open rates, click rates, that sort of thing. Low engagement rates could mean that your contacts aren't connecting with your message. High unsubscribe rates might signal that people didn't want messages to begin with. To an email service, too many unsubscribes could mean that email addresses came from a purchased list. Now I'll cover just two more points that are part of sender reputation. We've got IP reputation and domain reputation. An IP, or internet protocol, is a unique set of numbers that belong to a device or network. So your IP reputation is based on where your emails are being sent from, like which server. Your domain reputation is more specific to your business and sending practices. And it shows if your email domain can be trusted. If your domain is authenticated, it works like an ID. It's proof that it's really you. With all that goes into sender reputation, it's important to remember that deliverability is an ongoing process. Even if you run into issues, there are ways to improve things. And we'll get into those next. Let's talk about strategies you can use to improve your deliverability issues. Now, this is going to sound obvious, but it's crucial to maintain a clean audience. You want to regularly remove email addresses that are inactive, don't work, or belong to contacts who have marked your messages as spam. This will help you reduce your bounce rate and spam complaints. It's also helpful to use a double opt-in method. When a new subscriber signs up, they'll receive an email asking them to confirm it. So you'll validate their email address, which means it's less likely to bounce, and you'll be certain that you have someone's explicit consent to market to them. Raising your engagement rates can also improve deliverability. You know, opens, clicks, all that good stuff. If you want better engagement, a great place to start is with segmentation. To put that simply, it's grouping people together based on shared characteristics, like their purchasing behavior, location, and interests. We have a video on this too, just in case you're interested. But the main benefit is that segmentation helps you get the right message to the right person. With that said, engagement also depends on sending volume and frequency. See what you can learn from industry data and similar businesses. Your emails might not be effective if you're sending above or below industry average. And for businesses starting out, send your bulk messages in small batches, and try not to send every day, at least not until your reputation is more established. In general, If you're running into a lot of deliverability issues, it could be related to your sending domain. Authenticating your domain is becoming more important, especially if you want to meet the requirements of some major email services. Authentication shows your recipient's email server that you're a legitimate sender, and it helps protect your domain from being spoofed or impersonated by bad actors. Industry standards are also changing. Google and Yahoo require DKIM and DMARC authentication for large senders. In this case, a large sender is anyone who sends more than 5,000 emails to Gmail or Yahoo addresses within 24 hours. But even if you're a smaller sender, these policies could still affect you. Let's say you use a mail service provider like Mailchimp. If you have @gmail.com or @yahoo.com in your from address, this could cause delivery issues. If it's a Gmail domain, but the service that sends the message isn't Gmail, the message could be rejected or sent to spam, and the same goes for Yahoo. More services are likely to move in the same direction as Google and Yahoo, so I strongly encourage you to authenticate your domain. To sum things up, good deliverability practices increase your odds of landing in the inbox. There are some technical and compliance issues that affect this, but a lot has to do with creating quality and relevant content. Deliverability is the bridge to your customers, so it's a must-have for high-impact email marketing. Now, as promised, here are some next steps to improve your deliverability. If you're a MailChimp customer, first, watch our tutorial on how to authenticate your domain. If you don't use MailChimp, no worries. I have something for you too. Depending on your email domain provider, the process for creating DKIM and DMARC records can vary. But basically, you'll paste data from your mail service provider into your DNS settings. You may have to reach out to your website manager or domain registrar, but for now, here are some instructions for editing DNS settings with popular domain providers. And I've got one more bonus to help you out. It's a checklist to keep you on the right track. Feel free to pause and take a screenshot. Let us know in the comments how your deliverability is going. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.